and so on might be, making a benevolent appearance with us so that we can begin to know our origins and where we came from and actually
Everything.
start to reunite with the higher,
Yes.
those beings that have been around for millions and
Yeah,
billions of
but
years.
realize that those of us who are here on assignment, as it were, already know these things. So as we integrate more and more of who and what we really are at the soul level, we will know these things intuitively. They will just become part of our knowing, our consciousness. But for those who didn't come from there down to do this job, who are just on their way up, there will be many mechanisms of learning, and they will be taught. And as they become telepathic, they will absorb that higher consciousness of knowing as well. And we will repair the physical bodies of everybody on this planet as quickly as we can. It'll be done in stepwise fashion, as it has been, but at a much faster pace than we have seen before. We're at the crest of that wave where the water starts toppling over.
Oh,
You know?
yeah, it feels that
Yeah.
way. Well,
Yeah.
the death, disease, and all of that stuff is genetic manipulation, isn't it?
Absolutely. It
Yeah, of
absolutely
course. I
is.
mean, it can
It
only
was
be
always
that.
imposed. It was always imposed on this species. I mean, we had a time clock in our original design that was supposed to run about 1,000 years, depending on circumstances, nutrition, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But it was not uncommon to live for 1,000 years. But that was at a time, you're talking biblical time now, where the circumstances on this planet changed radically. That it doesn't describe why the planet was having floods, but it had lost both of its moons. Unfortunately, me and my team back at that time were cultivating this planet and bringing culture here and building high societies and using free energy, amplifying it off the crystals of this planet. And we had virtually had placed power stations in our pyramids and such at key locations that would cross through our cities and power them. And so even today, you can tell where the city centers were just by looking at where pyramids are and triangulating where they would line up on on the latitude lines.
And
And
they're all over the globe.
they're all over the
They're
globe.
all,
Yeah,
yeah, they're finding them, on the ley lines.
We had a lot of time, and we got a
Yeah.
lot done, and we had a lot of ability too, so it didn't really take as much time as one might think. But unfortunately, my team and I, we went a little too far, and we overstressed the crystal systems that were natural to Gaia. And
Yeah.
when they fractured, we lost our electromagnetic hold on both of our her moons. They floated away, and that's what caused all the floods. And we lost a lot of souls on our team and the humans that we had created here. And it was a horrible, horrible tragedy. And we certainly meant no harm, neither to our kind or the humans whom we made to be with us to do what we were doing to bring this planet into a glorious creation of self-sufficiency. I mean, everything worked according to the natural ebbs and flows of Gaia's own energies. But we should have tested a smaller sample before we implemented something so grand a scale. Unfortunately, I think there was an impatience to move ahead, maybe overconfidence from so many prior successes. But I think it perhaps was an arrogant mistake. We at the time were about where the humans are now in terms of arrogance and that, being overconfident and not realizing that there's limits to technology that require discipline and respect. And the kinds of things that humans are doing right now with genetic engineering were also mistakes that we were making then.
Yes,
And
yes.
just not respecting what was natural there, being impatient, wanting to change it, manipulating it to accommodate ourselves. And we learned a hard lesson that, there's karma in that because you're damaging something that was created by a divine entity with deliberation and forethought, created what's on themselves, each and every one of them. And so what we're basically saying is, you didn't do a good enough job, or this isn't good enough for me. However, whatever the intention is, the aims were, not in alignment with the planet, but realize that the Pleiadians, like the humans, were not telepathic then, you know, with the planet. I'm suspecting that, I'm not saying the Pleiades, let me back up the bus. There are many levels of Pleiadians. There are the ascended ones, and this is true of every species, by the way. We all have our ascended ones from the higher realms who are trying to leg up their younger ones coming up.
Uh-huh.
And so I want to clarify that, because the Pleiadians that Billy Meyer supposedly encountered were not the Pleiadians that I talk about most of the time, but right now it is. These were the ones, they were not ascended ones, and they're what we call the Anunnaki today. And so I just blended two stories, because there was the original family of Captain Jack that came here that was of a different, a higher evolved level of you know, the Pleiadian, or what I would say human ancestry, because this form is the Lyran, Pleiadian, Sirian, you know, form. Of course, all the star systems and galaxies have multitudes of forms in any given system, just like, you know, we have our mammals and our insect kingdom, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Well, when a planet or a system has been around long enough, all those things, the bugs and everything, become sentient. They self-modify their physical forms because they start learning by looking around them, you know. So something looks at something else and goes, wow, it'd be nice if I had hands too, you know. And so they start setting that intention up and start manifesting it, because in those other systems there's nothing to prevent it. Here on Earth, that was not the case.
In
all the lower realms, it's not the case, by the way. In all the lower realms, that's not the case.
Huh.
You know, that's something that you arrive at. It's not where you start.
Boy, we could do a whole another show on that. I wanted to ask you another question, so, because I know a lot of people are curious about this one. How significant is the Mayan calendar in the timing of all of these energies and shifts that we're going through?
It's a system, as most people know, has a lot of fudge factors built into it, and it measures more than one cycle. There's three great cycles that it measures in particular. There's a lot to that I haven't even studied, but what I can tell you is that the best way to describe that is, you know, it's the cogwheel of the cosmos. If nothing interfered and everything moved along exactly as predicted, then that thing would have happened right on the dot. However, that's not how it went down. And so there are variables now, because we have, our space brothers and sisters have ships large enough to actually push these objects around, and if needs be, blow one up. And so they've been blowing up large comets and asteroids that have been coming in towards Nibiru, which was coming from the south, acting like a magnet, pulling all this stuff from the asteroid belt and perhaps even further out, inward towards the sun, and we were in the way. So if you look at the progression of comets and asteroids in near-Earth orbit over the last 20 years, somebody put a video together and time-lapsed it, and you will see a dirty, dirty space here, pretty much evenly distributed everywhere, and then all of a sudden it starts getting all cleaned up. Until now, there isn't anything between Earth and Jupiter. It's clean as a whistle, folks. Because our friends have been taking care of that for us so that we didn't get hurt.
Now, what about the idea that there are space wars going on all over the place?
Yeah, there are. But realize that the upper hand is already is a predetermined, inescapable fact. And there had been wars for a long, long time because of Sagittarius B and the entities that she brought in here, in their immaturity, but big. And they unfortunately acquired technology from our system, which is quite advanced. And so you had these vicious entities who were not, could not have created, the kind of technology that they encountered. But encounter it they did, and it raised their ambitions and changed their thought process. And they came in possession of these things, and of course have been quite diabolical with them. So it's a regret. Yeah. It's a regrettable situation. But I want everybody to know that this is a problem that's been going on for millions of years, and now this is actually the last bastion of this for this system. We go up and out of this, and we'll never encounter such things ever again. We have served our time and risen to the goal of escaping all of that and taking with us all the experience we could possibly acquire over the amount of time allotted, which was quite extensive, about 11,000 years for this system.
That as we approach the end of the hour, that brings us to a hopeful note, which is where we started, where you did mention that we need not have any fear and to chill.
And to know that
you know, we're in good hands, but we can't. Well, what would you recommend that, you know, is there anything we can literally do, or is this just a matter
Something, just distract yourself with those things that make you happy, that make you feel fulfilled, that give you pleasure, make you smile, laugh, dance. Just dance like an idiot in your living room. Who cares? Distract yourself with joyful things, uplifting things, heartwarming things, instead of the kind of habits humans have fallen into with distraction.
I totally agree with you on that one.
Yeah, and really know that fear is a toxin. So is worry. It really will topple into fear.
Fear is a food for these entities to feed
off. Yeah. So you don't want to create that feedback loop that keeps dragging them towards us, just like mentioning them by species I was saying before, and with any kind of angst about it. You know, it's one thing to talk about the higher realm versions of these same exact entities that we encountered here that just aren't grown up enough yet, especially if they have the kind of technology they had. So dispense all fear. Simply do not give space to it, heart, mind, anything, and including giving ear to it to somebody else. Just say, you know what, I'm past that, and I hope that you will get past that as quickly as possible. Let me share the good news. We don't got to worry about that anymore. Let's move on. We got bigger fish to fry. Now it's called rebuilding utopia on this planet.
Wow. Well, you know, Colleen, it's been wonderful talking to you, and I want you to have a moment to mention where people can find you and where they can find your videos and so on and so forth.
Okay. Thank you for that. I am on YouTube on the Coles a Kick channel. That's Coleskick. And it's just kind of, you know, like, you know, I'm kind of a humorous girl. I live in the humor zone. That's my happy place. And so it's, Cole is a nickname of mine, so Cole's a Kick. They just don't allow the hyphen to make that a possessive. But also at www.wildcolleen.com. And I do have the Wild Colleen YouTube channel also, because they banned me for a month for violating their decency clause, which ironically, the smut that they allow on there for free, they have you rate a video adult, and I put an 18-year-old and above rental on there in their beta program. And I guess it was smutty enough because they banned me for what friends of mine have described as museum quality semi-nudes. And so I created that The Wild Colleen YouTube channel also for the month that I was being spanked by YouTube. and then I'm also at www.n5d.com, and that's IN5D.com. That's from Greg Prescott of the N5D channel, also on YouTube. And also he has his Mayan 2012 N5D focused website that is also has been quite a resource for those who were trying to increase awareness and brought towards awakening for their curiosity. Greg has been quite instrumental in feeding the flock down here what they needed to have.
Well, wonderful. Well, Colleen, this has been a terrific chat. I love talking to you. We'll have to have you back. And for the first day of the year of 2011, I'd say we're off to a pretty darn good start, don't you?
I concur.
All right.
Hallelujah.
Well, let's go have some fun and some laughter. And thanks so much for being on the show. And come back again, too, will you?
My sincerest pleasure. Thank you so much.
All right. All right. And good night, everybody. Thanks for listening. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Absolutely.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Of course.
Yes.
I mean, it could only do that.
Imposed. It was always imposed on the species. I mean, we had a time clock in our original design that was supposed to run about 1,000 years, depending on circumstances, nutrition, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But it was not uncommon to live for 1,000 years.
Right.
But that was at a time, you know, you're talking biblical time now, where, you know,
and so on might be, making a benevolent appearance with us so that we can begin to know our origins and where we came from and actually start to reunite with the higher, you know, those beings that have been around for millions and millions of years.
Yeah, but realize that those of us who are here on assignment, as it were, already know these things. So the circumstances on this planet changed radically. That it doesn't describe why the planet was having floods, but it had lost both of its moons. Unfortunately, me and my team back at that time were cultivating this planet and bringing culture here and building high societies and using free energy, amplifying as well. And we will repair the physical bodies of everybody on this planet as quickly as we can. It'll be done in stepwise fashion, as it has been, but at a much faster pace than we have seen before. We're at the crest of that wave where the water starts toppling over.
Oh, yeah,
you know?
It feels that way. Well,
yeah.
Death, disease, and all of that stuff is genetic manipulation, isn't it?
Yeah, but as we integrate more and more of who and what we really are at the soul level, we will know these things intuitively. They will just become part of our knowing, our consciousness. But for those who didn't come from there down to do this job, who are just on their way up, there will be many mechanisms of learning, and they will be taught. And as they become telepathic, they will absorb that higher consciousness of